Hey there, it's Katrina Sawa here, the Jumpstart Your Biz Coach with jumpstartyourmarketing.com and the new International Entrepreneur Network at iEntrepreneurNetwork.com, something super amazing for entrepreneurs to be able to get the answers to the questions you have every single day. You should go check it out. But I want to talk to you today on a quick business marketing tip, whatnot, about how to get more of your clients' attention via email, especially. And so clients and prospects, basically. So everybody that's on your email list. Now, first of all, we want to start thinking of them, if you aren't already, some of you might be, if you aren't already thinking about the people on your list, right? And rather than just thinking of them as your list, think of them as your community. We've got to make a change these days in how we're approaching quote unquote list building and community serving. So that's a mindset shift, because over the last, 16 years, maybe 14 years in my business, you know, it's been ingrained in me by coaches, mentors, speakers, workshops that we need to list build. And the one with the biggest list wins, right? And so but the world is changing, the marketplace is changing, and it is more about community, serving your community. And I get that if you are hurting for money, let's say, and it's hard to pay your bills and you're a little stressed out about money or a lot stressed out about money, it is hard to think about just serving and not offering and selling something. And that's not necessarily what I'm saying. I am saying that I do want you to make offers. I do want you to promote the things that you're selling. But I also want you to keep in mind how you can serve more, how you can give more deeper content, perhaps, or like the videos that I'm doing here, right? It's to give you better awareness. It's to give you more tips and strategies. It's to give you upcoming trends and what's working these days to grow your business. So how can you be that resource for your prospects and your clients in your community, right? Okay, so let's talk about though email marketing. It has changed dramatically. If you are still getting high open rates, then I applaud you, but it's not the norm, right? And a high open rate would be like 40 to 50% of the people that get your emails actually open it. A low open rate is under 10%. In the middle is actually you should celebrate. If you have anywhere from 10 to 30% open rate, you should be celebrating because you're not, a lot of people are under 10. But if the more people that open your emails, the more engaged and responsive your community is, which is amazing. So you're doing something right. Yay. What I would recommend is that we continue though to do email. We can't give up just because people aren't clicking and buying. Okay. A lot of times people will say, well, email's not working. I'm just not going to focus there. I think that's a huge mistake still to this day, even if you're getting low open rates. The key with low open rates is you have to get more creative with the subject line possibly. Okay. And you also have to make sure that the people that are in your community and on your email list, approved email list, mind you, that they are, they're actually approved to get, they agreed to get on your list. So I still, to this day, get emails from people who've either met me or found me online, who've added me to their email list without my approval. And that is still not, it's against the law, basically. It's against the law. It's spamming. So you don't want to do that, okay? You want to find a way to follow up with people that you've met, perhaps either by phone, direct mail, social media, and or a follow-up email to entice them to want to go become a part of your community and go online and sign themselves up for something. So you have to have stuff for free on your website, right? So that's how to get more people on your list in those ways. There's a lot of ways to do that. But what I want to talk to you today about is how you can get more nurturing and more response from your emails. Now, I'm constantly working on this myself. I don't have it all figured out. I don't have a 50% open rate. Okay. Full disclosure, I don't. But so I'm constantly working on this myself. And, but we have to keep, tweaking and changing and trying new things, or it's not going to work anyways, right? So here's some ideas that might help you in your email marketing. Okay. Now, when you are sending emails, you can't just send one a month. You're just going to be way too out of mind. They'll forget about you in 30 days. Okay. They're going to forget about you in 30 days. So you have to send more than one a month. I recommend at the very minimum once every other week. Okay. And now it's still okay to send a weekly email as long as it's not sales pitch, sales pitch, sales pitch, sales pitch, right? You want to nurture and educate and inspire and tell stories and tell your own what's going on with you. So there's things, so I have a little checklist here that I just wrote in an email newsletter to my community. So send them stuff based on your life when you want to send them. So people ask me all the time, well, when's the perfect time to send an email newsletter? And there is no perfect time, okay? There's no perfect time to send your email newsletter. Think about your target market though, like your ideal client. Think about, do they have a job 9 to 5? Are they actually, you know, opening during that time? Or are they more busy type of professional and they only check in on the evenings and weekends? Then consider doing it in the evening or weekend, right? Or a lot of people will tell you, oh, you have to do it at 4 a.m. or something. And that's ridiculous. First of all, is it 4 a.m. Pacific or 4 a.m. Eastern? And if you have people all over the world, I mean, really, is it 4 a.m.? So that's just kind of a silly standard that people will say. and I do agree with like not Mondays, because Mondays seem to be a little back to work hectic for people, and maybe not even Fridays, because Fridays they're checked out, they're thinking about the weekend. So unless your business has something to do with fun and weekend activities or something like that, then Friday morning might be great, or Thursday afternoon might be great for them to think about something for the weekend. So think about your target audience and your ideal client, but also think about when you want to send them. So when are you going to actually sit down and write that email consistent with the day? Okay, so I'll send it whenever I can, but it's usually Wednesday or Thursday, and occasionally I'll send an email on a Friday or Saturday. And people do open on the weekends too, because the people that I talk to are all entrepreneurs. So when to send it, it's up to you. Just pick a time and do it. Stop, you know, overthinking it is my advice. What to send. So send stuff that's relevant to your clients and your community. What do they need? What do they, for the majority of them, what do they need? What do they want? What are they looking for? What are they searching for? My audience is looking for strategic marketing and business strategies. They want to know how to get more clients, how to make more money, how to stop working so hard, how to do bigger things, how to level up in their business and become a speaker or do live events or charge more, you know, get more confidence. And that's what my audience wants. And I know that because I do a lot of networking. I go to a lot of events. I speak at a lot of events. I have a lot of virtual masterminds on Zoom and things like that, and I just hear their challenges. So if you don't know what they want, you have to ask them, you have to get involved, you have to start asking questions of people when you're out and about, and you have to learn, right? You have to learn and then give them what they need. Now, and if what they need is not necessarily your expertise or what you offer, then you can bring in guest experts. You can do guest expert interviews. You can do guest expert articles or videos, or you can interview other people to give your audience what they need. But hopefully they're there because they need what you have in some way or another. Okay. Now, other things you can send, you can tell stories and get personal with them. So tell your own stories. What's going on with you? I will usually interject things in a video. Sometimes in the email newsletter as well, it's, you know, I do more in video because it's easier for me to just talk through something in 15 or 20 minutes than it is to write it out on 4 pages in an email that nobody wants to read, right? So so I will share the stories of things that happened to me in those ways, okay? But you got to share what you can't keep personal and business separate anymore, especially if you're an entrepreneur, because people like, trust, and connect with you because of you, not because of you sell this widget or service. So make sure you're getting personal with your community. Tell stories about client successes and people that you're working with. You don't have to share names if you don't want to, but say I had this client, let's call her Susan, who came to me with this challenge, and we worked with her for a couple months, and boy, on the other end, she just did this amazing thing. And then there you go, right? And you can tell a story, and then that showcases what you've done with her, excuse me, as well as give some level of content about what they might be going through. And stop worrying how long the email has to be. People always say, well, how long does it have to be? 300 words, 500 words? It doesn't matter. What matters is that it's clear and concise, and it's either story written, and people will read a story if they're engaged, or it's, you know, bullet point content written, or, and if they're interested in the topic, they'll read the tips that you're sharing, right? And then, of course, have some call to action in your email, even if it's just a small little line, a one-liner underneath your signature line for the PS. You know, you can also have a section for upcoming events or featured programs or special of the month or product of the month or whatever you want to do. You can have something in an email newsletter. Another thing is you don't have to necessarily format it like a newsletter where you have the intro, the body, the content, the different sections. You don't have to format it like that. You can. My brain works like that. And because I have so much going on, I think it's easier for people to read if I have, you know, the initial story or intro, the body of content, and then I have upcoming events and perhaps a client testimonial. I mean, if they want to read more, they can. If they don't, then they don't have to, right? They can just go to the featured article. So however your brain wants to structure it, your people probably appreciate it also, because like attracts like. So there you go. And just really, I mean, you just want to communicate, share, inspire, educate, and relate to them. Honestly, if you just do that more often, whether it's two paragraph of an email, whether you shoot a video like this, and then you link it inside the email to go out to your YouTube and watch it, with a little bit of text around it of why they should click and watch, right? Don't just put a video in there and then say, here, watch my video newsletter for the day. You know, because then we're like, well, what's it about? I'm not going to click and watch it if you don't tell me a little bit about what it's about and what you're talking about. they won't click to watch that. And you also don't need fancy software templates or designs or logos to send emails. You could just send a text email with your full signature line of, you know, your full name, your title, your phone number, your email address, your website, a PS perhaps. That's a full signature line. Please put that in all your emails so they can contact you. Don't make it hard for them to contact you if they want to know more. That's kind of silly, right? So, but you do need to be compliant, like I said, with making sure people have agreed to get your emails, and then making sure you are using some kind of software to send the email. It doesn't have to be fancy, like I said, like Infusionsoft or Entreport or Kartra or any of those. You don't have to use those, okay? And don't let anybody tell you you do. You can use a more affordable software depending on what you're selling. Either I recommend a shopping cart that has the email marketing inside as well as taking payments. That's all in one system, so you don't have to have two systems. Or just an email marketing system. If you're not really taking payments on your website and stuff like that, then you can just do a regular email marketing system like Constant Contact or AWeber. But pick something, because those systems will have the unsubscribe links and all the required stuff. And there's some specific required things these days on email, in case you aren't aware. You have to have a full physical address for your business in your emails. Well, it doesn't have to be physical. Like, I have a PO box, right? So I have a PO box for my business, but the address has to be in there. You have to have an address these days, and you should have it anyways. As a professional business owner, you should have your address on your social media profiles, on your website, on your business card, and in your emails. Plain and simple. Don't be some, oh, I'm not giving my address out because I work from home. No, figure it out and get serious with an address, please. So you look more professional, you look more, they'll trust you more if you have an address, okay? And honestly, to get more attention to your emails, just get really creative. Give awesome value and be accessible, right? Did you know that I read every single email that comes across my desk? Every single email. I don't care which email address you have of mine. They all come to me. Okay. Some people actually think that I have an assistant who reads my emails first or writes the email newsletters, and I don't. It's all me because I am the one that wants to communicate with my community. I want to hear from people. I want to hear from you from videos too. Good or bad, it's the things that I send in my email, that's what's on my mind and the minds of my clients currently. So whatever I'm writing about or talking about in these videos, this is what's going on in the marketplace with my clients on a daily basis. And usually after two or three clients mention something, that's when an article or a video comes out, because I'm like, if these guys are talking about it, I'll bet a whole bunch more people are talking about this, right? So finally, please have fun with your emails. You can delegate some of this. So if you want to write it in Word and then send it off to an assistant and they do all the technical stuff and send it out, you can do that. If you need help or need a virtual assistant who can do that for you, contact me. I'll give you referrals, or my company has a virtual techie team as well, so we can do it for you. Just stop making excuses and stop making it hard, and just figure out how to make it easier for you to get this done and communicate more with your community, because they are in your community for a reason. They want to hear your genius, your gifts. They want to hear your expertise. You have expertise to share with them. You are amazing, and you need to share more often. People are waiting to hear from you. So hopefully that's helpful. Hopefully you can make some goals and some schedules around your email marketing from here. And please reach out if you have any questions or want some help, because this is not rocket science. This is just a little bit of nurturing to your community that is a must in this day and age for marketing and follow-up. So Katrina Sawa signing off. Remember to go to jumpstartyourmarketing.com for a lot more information. To get on my email newsletter, just go there /newsletter, and you can sign up for my email newsletter and get even more great content and tips in your inbox. Plus, you'll find out when all the fabulous events are that I'm hosting online and offline. And the one thing that I'm super excited about this right now is the International Entrepreneur Network. So if you know that you need some little tweaks and little advice and little help and feedback, you know, on a weekly or monthly basis, then for $7 a month, you can join the International Entrepreneur Network and come and mastermind with us on Zoom 2 to 3 times a month, plus have a private Facebook group where all of us are focused on helping each other grow and get the answers to your questions, so you stop being stuck in making a decision about something. And I want you to build the business the most affordable way possible. So please ask before you invest in certain things that maybe one person recommends, when we just haven't looked at all your options yet, right? I love to help people look at all their options and then pick the right thing for you, regardless of cost or if I'm making money on it or anything like that. So be careful who you're listening to. I would love to be a resource for you. Go to iEntrepreneurNetwork.com, the letter I, EntrepreneurNetwork.com, and sign up and join us. For $7 a month, it's kind of a no-brainer. Okay, have a great day, you guys. We'll talk to you soon. Bye.